Actually, the first draft was much longer. And
Yeah.
then my publisher just sort of freaked out and said, this is just too long. And I reduced it. So what you see is a reduced version of the book. And you know, I understand that it is sometimes a little frightening when you are, you know, presented with a book which is, I think it's almost 600 pages, but that's not 600 pages of text. There are end notes and there's bibliography. But I think the length was important to me because I didn't want to sacrifice detail. I wanted to give the reader a flavor of what the original texts were saying. And I wanted them to understand the nuances of the debates about political violence in ancient India. So the book had to be a rather somewhat long book. But you know what made the book really easy to write and a joy to write was the fact that the ancient sources have so much to say about these things. I didn't have to look for the references or the evidence. All of them talk so much and they talk so elegantly and so engagingly about these issues. So that made it a pleasure to actually research the book. And I hope that the book conveys some of that pleasure to the reader. Because, you know, when I wrote this book, I was quite clear that I wanted it to be something that ordinary, interested people who are curious about ancient India could read and enjoy. And you're right, there's a huge gap between the world of the historian and ordinary, interested people. And that's why that gap, that space gets occupied by very uninformed and very questionable kinds of, you know, discourses about the past. It's important for historians to actually write in a way that people can understand history, and they can understand that history is not just anything that you might say about the past. The discipline of history has certain, there is a historical method. You have to analyze your sources, you have to respect the chronology of the sources, and your analysis must be something that is internally consistent, so on and so forth. So every profession has a certain method. There are certain skills that are required, you know, whether you're a doctor or an engineer or in this case a historian. And I think it's important for people to realize that the historian's craft also is a discipline which requires an understanding of the sources, which requires certain arguments that are made about the past. And you can't have an anything goes attitude. That's something that ordinary people really need to be aware of.